Okay, hello. This is my overview, my little review of this month's issue of Guitar World. Technically, it's the August issue, but for some reason, these magazine companies like to release stuff a few months earlier than what's stated actually inside. So, as you can see here, it's the 100 Greatest Classic Rock Guitar Songs this month. I wonder how accurate this truly is. Nah, I don't wonder. I've already read the majority of the list. And, ironically, my list didn't come with a disc. I only got this today. I just came to college, and, I actually got this in the mail, just today. From my parents, who know that I'm a big guitar fan, and since I was not able to bring my guitar itself to university with me, I'll have to wait until a few months later when I go off to my co-op. They decided to get me a Guitar World magazine, and I made me a subscription. I need to ask them if they got me a subscription because I honestly don't know, because it still has the things, the little slips in there that says subscribe to Guitar World magazine, but the thing was, the DVD didn't come in the CD did not come with it. Usually, when it comes from, it's the CD is usually in it, but it wasn't in it in this time. So I was kind of, that was a little strange, but I guess it's okay. So, yep, the big story here is 100 Greatest Classic Rock Guitar Songs. So let's just go through the top 10 here. Number 1, Johnny B. Goode by Chuck Berry, classic rock and roll song. And although some people might be thinking Jimi Hendrix should be on top, I can't agree more. Johnny B. Goode has got to be on top. The only problem there is that every single person almost every single person that's covered this song, covered Johnny B. Goode, has butchered it. Everybody from Everybody from George Thorogood to Judas Priest has just totally, totally butchered that song. Oops. Please, do not cover that song. It's not a song that's meant to be covered. It's a classic. You just don't fuck with the classics, for God's sake. Number 2, Stairway to Heaven. No surprise there. No surprise there. I'm kind of, although I personally think that there was much better guitar songs that Led Zeppelin did than Stairway to Heaven, like Whole Lot of Love, Immigrant Song, Heartbreaker. Purple Haze is in third. Oh, now you Hendrix lovers finally get it there. Sweet Child of Mine. Oh God, fourth. Sweet Child of Mine. I can't believe that they would put Sweet Child of Mine in fourth on this list. It's a terrible, just terrible. I don't know. Just a terribly overrated song. Should not even be in the top 10. Enter Sandman. And the album that Metallica sold out, and they have Scott Ian commenting here, saying that it was like the Back in Black of heavy metal. Super overrated and over commercialized beyond belief. Absolutely. Up next is Hotel California by the Eagles. Correction, Eagles. Everybody calls them the Eagles. The name of the band is Eagles, not The Eagles. Okay? Okay. We got that taken care of. It's just Eagles. Alright, so then we have Crazy Train by Ozzy Osbourne, 7th, Randy Rhoads on guitar. Now, that's... I'm sorry, people, but Crazy Train is an overrated riff. I hear it on the radio. It's just like one of those songs that you like hear on the radio all the time and you get totally annoyed of. You don't even listen to the radio anymore because of songs like this. I mean, there's just too many songs that are like overplayed, and I'm kind of surprised, you know, I'm kind of surprised that Crazy Train came above any Black Sabbath song, because you would think they would be intelligent enough to put Black Sabbath before anything that Randy Rhoads, put stuff made by Black Sabbath before anything that Randy Rhoads ever did. Eruption Slash really got me. Kind of have some problems there. As, not on Van Halen themselves. Van Halen is a great hard rock band, but, I don't really think, but seriously, Eruption, I guess so, but You Really Got Me, it's a cover. It's a cover. They might as well have just put the Kinks version in there. Smoke on the Water. I personally feel that Highway Star was a bit more of an influential riff. Smoke on the Water was just the big hit, I guess, is why they put it up here. But still, I have to say that Highway Star was way more influential on that point. Well, another overrated hard rock band. And I'm surprised that this one came lower than Guns N' Roses Atrocity. Back in Black by AC/DC. Another Atrocity, by the way. It's really just one of those songs that just makes me cringe. I mean, especially with Brian Johnson on vocals. I mean, AC/DC was at least an average band without when they had Bon Scott. But then Brian Johnson came in, and his vocals just destroyed everything. Everything completely. There was nothing really good. He's just a terrible vocalist. And I'm not an AC/DC fan, by the way, And even then, I still have to say Brian Johnson is a terrible vocalist. The riff is highly overrated and simplistic. We finally get Iron Man. Iron Man really should have been in the top 10. Actually, probably Iron Man should have been the only metal song in the top 10. I don't know exactly why they needed two. Crazy Train probably could have gone lower. I mean, like, 20s lower. And Enter Sandman shouldn't have even been on this list. They should have put, like, Master of Puppets or Battery or something like that. Something off of their earlier days that actually had an impact on heavy metal. Another thing is classic rock. I would call that classic rock, essentially. Although I would say, you could probably say that for Iron Man. But Iron Man is a pretty... But yeah, Iron Man, I could see why it's so highly ranked, why it should be in the top 10. And then just got a whole bunch of gear reviews. Lessons this week are from David Ellison, Metal Mike Chlodzak, okay, John Five. I forgot what the other guy's name was from that one Degent band. Misha Mansour. I'm not a fan of Degent, by the way, that much. Aside from Meshuggah, I really can't stand it that much. I prefer more traditional progressive metal, like Fate's Warning, Psychotic Waltz, you know. Talking Blues with Keith Wyatt, Dale Turner, in deep with Andy Aldort. I kind of wonder when that's going to end, because it's kind of been going on for a while now. Although then again, the Alchemical Guitarist did go on for a pretty long time too, and that was a great column, I must say, the Alchemical Guitarist. Ed Shed, well, that's been going on for a while, but that one can stay, just purely because it's about guitar maintenance. And then the songs for the week, that were transcribed for the week, are, surprisingly, there was, okay, maybe you could say so for We're an American Band, but there's no real, like, hard rock or heavy metal songs on here. Like, there's no, they've got Day of the Eagle by Robin Trower, We're an American Band by Grand Funk Railroad, I Can't Get No Satisfaction by the Rolling Stones, Sultans of Swing by Dire Straits, and Reel in the Years by Steely Dan. The only one I'd have any interest in really learning would be Sultans of Swing, and even then, I'm not that good of a finger picker, and I really wouldn't want to put much time into a song that I'm not going to play that much, that wouldn't play that much, seeing as I'm more into hard rock and heavy metal, particularly the latter, not so much the earlier. Actually, I'm really not that into hard rock, I'm more just into heavy metal. There are some hard rock bands that I do like early Van Halen, Thin Lizzy, but, you know, not that much. Overall, I'd probably give this, a 7 out of 10. It's a kind of weak, especially the list. The list starts out okay, but it gets progressive, but the problem is there's just so many songs that are kind of like thrown around there that should be either much lower or much higher than they are. So yeah, I personally feel that it's okay, nothing really great personally, could have been better, but good lessons in there though, by the way, but I'm not really interested in a lot of the gear, not really interested. Some of this is just might be just personal bias in here, but I wasn't really interested in a lot of the gear that was presented, and the songs also don't really interest me that much either. I would like to say we should try to get like maybe one of everything on each issue, just so that pretty much any reader is going to read at least one of their tabs, but none of these tabs really interest me. So that's all for now. Take care, you guys. If you want to have like any metal CD, metal album reviews of any sort, you can go ahead and request it on my channel. Until then, take care.